Hey, Dale. Does that look blurry? Me just see. Does that look blurry? Looks a little blurry on this end. Just wait a couple minutes. So I got on a little early. Hopefully I have everything set and ready to go. You know what usually happens, never fails. Okay. Well, it's just us girls here right now. Don't forget about your flex points. I know we talked about it, Nan. I don't know about yours, but Ellen, yeah, it's, I thought it was slightly off. Those flex points. Will be disappearing. Yeah, it is off tonight. I don't know why. Okay. So tonight we are going to create this card, which I made with the Forever Fern. Let me just get my cat down here for a minute. Get down, buddy. If you remember during the week, I did it in the espresso early. Espresso and the very vanilla. Well, tonight I decided to do it in Pretty Peacock and Bermuda Bay. I mean, it's amazing. Same card, different colors. Yeah, I think for 700, Ellen, you can get a $5 coupon. I know, you know that one is available. I don't know how many you have, but just make sure you check. But what a difference. Just gonna change the light a little bit. Okay, and then to go with it is this cute little picnic basket. And I have a what is it, a Ferrero Rocher and a K-cup. I mean, you could put two of these little candies, whatever you wanted. It's just a cute little basket. I'm going to take this off because I honestly did not pull out another little plastic bag. But I'll take it out so you can see. But it's cute. If we ever get out of this lockdown, it would be great for a craft fair because it is so quick and easy to make. And it's really cute. So, let's just see. Yeah, I know it is off. I'm not sure what the problem is. Thanks, Nan. So, let's get started. We'll start with the card. And I have all my layers here. We're starting off with our normal base, which is 8.5 by 5.5. And we're just going to fold this over. And this is the Bermuda Bay. And then I have the Pretty Peacock. And this is an eighth of an inch, so it's 5 3/8 by 4 1/8. And excuse me, I ran it through the Stampin' Emboss machine with the subtle embossing folder. Let me just grab a drink. I know. Actually, look, I did save one. I put one in here and I saved one so I can make one tonight. I was tempted, but I do have that candy box in here with the Kit Kats and the Twix bars. So if I get desperate, that's where I take it from. So, like I said, I ran this through with the subtle embossing folder, and we want to glue this down instead of using the stamp and seal because we don't want to flatten out the nice embossing. Let me just poke this a little bit. I didn't put my lid back on, so there we go. So we don't want to crush our embossing. Plus, it just gives us a little bit of time to maneuver this around a little just to make sure it's on here straight. Now, if I was going to pop this up, I would actually put a layer of Bermuda Bay this size and then have cut this piece an eighth of an inch shorter. Because the paper, when you emboss it with the subtle, it makes it very flimsy. Have a Twix, it's better than. Hey, Kathleen, how are you? You like Twix better than Kit Kats? Okay, so what I did next was this is the gold laser cut specialty paper that comes in the suite. For the Forever Greenery. So instead of using the gold side, which I could have, I decided to use the white side only because since I am stamping the images on white cardstock, I think if it was on the gold, the white would just stand out just a little bit too much. So I decided to turn it so we use the white side. Now, when we adhere this, you just want to put a little bit of glue. You don't want to put too much. Just dab it all around. Because on this one, if you look real close, I did move it a little bit, and you can actually see the shininess of the glue. So we're just going to see what it see, just like that. That's exactly what I did with the other one. So we're just going to place this down, and I don't even think I have a tissue or a rag in here. Yes, I do. I'm just going to run this down here before and just tack that down just like that. Then I grabbed the Bermuda Bay so it offsets the color a little bit. You can notice it. And this is a 1-inch piece, and I do have to cut it down. And then I took the Pretty Peacock and using the embossing folder that comes with the Forever Greenery, and it's the Greenery embossing folder, I embossed it. Now, when you do emboss it using this embossing folder, yeah, you really do have to, where it's a short little piece, try to line it up a little bit. So your lines are straight, and you will notice that when you put the paper in, let's grab one here. When you put the paper in, I don't know if you hear that, but you can snap it closed. Because I did notice when I did this, you had to be really careful and either hold it together really well. Because the paper did have a tendency to slide in this embossing folder. but it does snap closed a little bit. So we're going to grab, and I forgot to the little piece of paper with the name of this punch. Let's see if I can find it in here. I think it's pick a label, because I was trying to find the other label. And if anybody knows what this, the name of this label punch is, I could not find it. So if anybody knows offhand what the name of this one is, I would appreciate it. But I think this one is the pick a label punch. And we are just going to insert this in. Now this is an inch, and this one's pretty good. When you look at the other end, it does punch it really well. With this one, it's a little bit too small for the inch, but it is too big for the next layer. So when I stick it in, I'm just turning it over to make sure that this little rounded piece is pretty centered. I don't want it off too much. Just move it over a little bit and give it a punch. And I am going to glue these two together, and then we will trim it down. And again, we're going to use glue on the embossed piece because we don't want to crush the embossing. And I'm just going to leave a very tiny little piece. Move it down just a tad. Again, the glue helps, so you can move it just a little bit. And this is going to be the piece that lays here. So let's just get our little trimmer, and we're going to just trim this down so it has a nice straight edge. And we're just going to adhere this to the front of the card. Yes, that's true, Nan. That is a great cloud punch. And like I said, I have looked even in last year's catalog. I'm going to have to check to see. I have not been able to find that punch. I'm thinking it belongs to a stamp set, and it was in a bundle, and that's why I couldn't find it. So that's exactly what I'll be looking for, to see what the name of this, because it doesn't even have a product number on it that I can look it up. Okay, so we glued that down. Then what I did was taking this punch that has boggled the mind. I punched out this little piece in the Bermuda Bay, and all I'm going to do is cut it in half, just like that, and put it aside. Then we're going to take a piece of our cardstock, and we are going to take our sentiment. I have a question for everybody. How do you clean your blocks? Has anyone ever put them in the dishwasher? Because mine are looking pretty cruddy. And I did clean them. I'm stamping the sentiment. and I did it in Pretty Peacock. They're looking a little cruddy, and I tried using a cloth and some bleach and water, and it just really made them a little cloudy. So I'm wondering, does anyone have a tip on cleaning the blocks? I would appreciate it. And then same punch. We're just going to line this sentiment up. And actually what I did was lined up the word smile, making sure it's straight, because actually the words in this sentiment are all in different directions. So I actually use the smile to get it punched out, just like that. That punch away. And I am just going to take these two pieces and I'm going to glue each half one to the top and one to the bottom. And if you move it around a little bit, you really can get these two edges to be tucked right behind this side of the, I'll call it the little cloud, like Nan said. And then we're going to do the same. And you just want to be careful while you're doing this side, because the one we just put on is still not dry and it will have a tendency to move. But we're going to stick this one on. Make sure our edges are tucked in. And this just helps the sentiment stand out a little bit. Now, while that's drying, I'm just going to take my dark Bermuda Bay and I'm just going to color two of these clear dots so it matches. And we're going to pop this sentiment up on the front of the card. Grab my scissors, Dawn dish soap and water. Oh, eyeglass cleaner. That's true. I didn't even think of that. Good idea, man. Yeah, like I said, the bleach just made it a little bit cloudy. So now I'm only going to put my dimensionals on either side because I want to leave some room so I can tuck my leaves under without the dimensionals getting in the way. So I'm just going to center this on this little tag, leaving a little bit more room on the top of the tag that I have down than the bottom. While they're drying, I used this fern type stamp, and I actually did this one in the Pretty Peacock. So we're just going to stamp. Now we need two of these, and I don't think I'll be able to get two on here, but we would need two. And then with the coordinating die, we would cut them out. And I already did that, so we don't have to jump up. And then in the Bermuda Bay, just put this aside. I grabbed the smaller of the leaves, and I've been trying to use up all my little pieces that I have. And we're going to just stamp this one in Bermuda Bay, and we're going to do it two times. And again, it has a coordinating die. And actually, this leaf does come in the opposite direction too, which I will be using for the inside of the card. So we're just going to die cut that. And I did that there. So it does have the coordinating dies for these leaves. No fussy cutting on these. Although I really don't mind fussy cutting. And all I did was I added a little glue to the back. And we're just going to tuck it under. Just like that. And the same on the bottom. And this is exactly the way I did the early espresso and the very vanilla. Same exact way. The only difference is I used soft suede. And what was the other color? Soft suede and let me just look for you. I don't think I used early espresso. It was soft suede. And the cinnamon cider, I believe I used. I'll have to double check that. So we just tuck these under. And then we're going to grab our, these should be dry now. And we're just going to stick these. You want to make sure they're dry because I have done this where they weren't completely dry and I smeared the ink onto my white. So that's the front of the card. Let's get rid of this. We don't need these anymore. Now for the inside. Now this twine is no longer available, but it fit this card really well. This was, that one was too, and I forgot the name. Emma, I think I gave it to you. Yes, I do clean them off, but I have to use them again. See, I have my little scrubber, and I do actually have the cleaning stamp cleaner, but I just like this one. Em, I think I had gave you that birthday one. It went to the set with these little guys, the little penguin. And that's where that twine came from. So I have my pretty peacock, and this is 5 3/8 by 4 1/8. And I should remind you that I will have the PDFs and all the measurements in the group tomorrow for the card and the little basket, but it probably will not be until the afternoon. We have a run to the VA in the morning, and who knows how long that's going to take because they changed up the way they're letting people in. So we could be there for hours. Okay, so we're going to take the small little leaf stamp, and oh, that's not too bad. And I'm just going to center this, and this is the one that is facing to the right. And I'm just going to give that a quick stamp. And let me just clean this so I don't get ink on my fingers when I pull it off. And then I'm going to take the other one that's facing the left when we stamp it. And we're just going to put it right next to it. And this is in the Bermuda Bay, the lighter of the two colors we're using. And then we're going to pull out the pretty peacock. And we're using the same leaves that we used on the front. You know, I like to match my inside and my outside. And we're just going to put one leaf on that side, one leaf on that side. And you can see, check out the difference. Ooh, look at the shadow. Look at the difference in the color because it's not dry yet. So we'll give that a minute to dry. Clean off this stamp because we're done with it now. You're right, man. Boy, it's been raining here all day today. Thank goodness, though, it's not snow. I think we're supposed to have frost tonight. So hopefully the rain will be gone. So it's not icy tomorrow. Okay, so we're just going to layer this down on my pretty peacock. Just like that. And then we're going to take the twine. And we're going to tie this in a nice little bow at the bottom. And what I like to do with twine is tie it in a knot first, because it does make tying the bow a little easier. Okay. There we go. Just cut this. Tie it in the bow. My nails are getting too long. Okay. Now, when you tie your bow, if you hold down on the knot when you pull your little tails, it usually keeps your little loops nice and neat so they don't curl up. Trim this down. And then we're going to make sure we glue this into the right card this week. I don't know if you were here and remember last week, I ended up putting the center of the card in the card that was already completed. So I had to take the middle of that card out and redo the whole inside of the card. Okay, let's make sure we got this down. If you see a little spot, and it's okay now, but if you ever see a little spot that is sticking up, if you take a piece of cardstock and add glue, you can just like stick it under and hold down and pull it out, and you'll get glue under that spot. But there's the card. Quick and easy and very pretty. Okay. Now we're going to jump to this cute little box. Looks like a little picnic basket. And like I said, I think it would be a perfect, excuse me, a perfect little craft fair box. Okay, I didn't score this little piece. So let's just pull our scoreboard up. And this piece is actually 2.5 by 4. So what we're going to do is score it at 1/2 and then 3/2, and then turn it and score it at 1/2 and 2. So it's a half inch scored around each side. Quick and easy. Now this is the little base. So what we're going to do, let's fold and get nice lines for this box. Go around all four sides. This is such a quick and easy project. And we're just going to cut on these little score lines to create our tabs. We're not even going to notch it because we're going to put these tabs on the outside of this little box. So we're going to turn it over and we're just going to use some stamp and seal. And I didn't flick my wrist as you saw. And we're just going to we go. Gonna hit this one again. I said the in outside, right? I did it on the inside. You really do want to put these on the outside. So we're just gonna fold these the other way. So I'll make sure I write that down in the directions. You want these little flaps on the outside of this little tray. So this way you have a nice clean inside for your box. And you want to just make sure that it's even. On all four corners. And there you have your little tray. Okay, so all your tabs are on the outside. Then I took a piece of the DSP, and this is actually 1.5 by 10. You want to make sure that if it is patterned where you need a top and a bottom, that you do it, you add your tearing tape to the right spot. And I think with the leaves facing up, we'll make this side the bottom. So I'm just going to turn it over and we're going to make sure I did that right. Add our tearing tape to the bottom of this piece. All the way across. Now we'll start adding it on. So this will be our end piece that will wrap around last. So we have our tearing tape across the bottom and one end. And we're just going to remove the paper. You know how I usually say I don't like removing all the paper at the same time, but we'll give it a shot. And we're just going to start about halfway on the box. And I'm just going to lean it down against the table, and I'm going to pull the box up to the piece of paper to get me started. Then this way we have a nice straight edge on the bottom. And we're not going to fold at the corners, but we're just going to wrap this around each side, making sure that we keep it level with the bottom of the box. Now remember, tearing tape is really not that forgiving, so you want to make sure that when you press it down, that's exactly where you want it. And we're just going to wrap it around this next side, making sure we keep it pretty even. just like that, and then come around the last side. And there you go, that's the little base to your basket. Nice and quick and easy. And for our handles, this is 3/8 by 4. And you want to take your bone folder and we want to break up the fibers that are in the paper so it curls nicely without ripping it. Just like that. And we're going to take some glue dots. And I'm still using glue dots from one of my paper pumpkin kits. And we're going to put the glue dots on the edge or at the end of the piece on the same side and attach it to this little basket. The only thing about these glue dots is removing these pieces of paper. So we'll start with the back. And here's about halfway, so we'll just stick it over to that side a little. And then we're just going to wrap this and then stick the other handle down just like that. Now we don't, these little glue dots are not going to hold this handle in place. This is just to hold it for now so we can wrap the band. So you don't have to worry too much about it slipping and sliding. That's just, this glue dot is just to hold it in place so we get that band wrapped, because that will be what holds it in place. Okay, so we got the paper off and we're going to do the same thing. You want to make sure you're at least ballpark to where the other handle was put on in the back. And that looks about right. We'll just move, scooch this down a little bit. Okay. Now we have a piece that is 1/2 by 10 inches. And for this piece, and I'm just looking to see how I cut this, you'll always notice on one edge where you cut, you'll have a little ridge. So I always make that the back side. And again, we're going to just take a piece of tear and tape and put it closer to one end than the other. And we're going to run it down the whole length, just like that. Make sure it's secure. I'm going to remove this paper. Now, we want to start on the same side where we have our little seam already. Little piece of paper stuck here. And we're going to line this up to the top of this little basket. And this will hold those handles in place now. And we're going to wrap it right around this little basket along the edge so it's even, and it's going to hold down these little straps. And we're going to continue around making sure it's right at that edge. Just like that. And then make sure it's even. And then there is the rim to your basket. Nice and quick and easy. Now what I did for the inside of the box, actually, I just opened up one of my paper pumpkin boxes and cut off a piece of tissue paper. You could use shredded paper and just stick it inside. You could stick your little candy and your K-cup. And I used the sentiment hello and I stamped it in Pretty Peacock. Just like that. And I'm using the classic label die and I'm actually moving it so the hello is closer to one of the corners than the other. Hi, Debbie. That's okay. Thanks for sharing. Okay, so there we have our hello. I'm just gonna trim this side off a little bit. And then we are going to do the same thing. We just want a little piece. And I actually just grabbed that out of the garbage. And we're just going to tuck this again, just so it stands out a little bit. We have the Pretty Peacock in the ink and the Bermuda Bay on the paper. And we're just going to take a glue dot and we're going to adhere this right to the little basket. And then we're going to take the reversible ribbon. One side is the Pretty Peacock. And it just says reversible ribbon on the Old Olive and Pretty Peacock reversible ribbon. And we're just going to tie a bow. Quick and easy. Tuck that in. Give it a good pull. What do you need to do? Yeah, the basket is cute. It's a cute little, it would be great for, like I said, a craft fair or, you know, for if you were having guests. You could put a little treat in it at the table. It's just a very cute little, a little gift for your waiter or waitress. Could be used for so many different things. And it's so quick and easy. Doesn't require much paper. You could really get a few of those done. Okay, so we're just going to cut this ribbon. Grab another glue dot, and we're just going to stick this ribbon right at the end of this little sentiment. Pull that paper off. Attach our ribbon. Just like that. And if you wanted, you could put it in a little bag. I actually put it in a little treat bag, which should be a little bit larger, I believe. This is 4x6. You may want to get one that's about 4x8 because it was a little tight to tie the ribbon. But there are tonight's projects. Quick and easy, really pretty. And you could actually, like I said, do them in any color. Now with this card, I actually have it opening this way, where this one I did. But you, the color, you could use many, many different colors. So I hope you enjoyed tonight's projects. Thank you all for being here tonight. Like I said, I will have the PDF in the group tomorrow, but it probably will not be until the afternoon. And hey, Kathy, I didn't even see you come in. I'm so happy you were all here with me tonight. I will see you tomorrow. I do have, I go live on YouTube on Tuesdays. I've been doing a few different things, coloring, making cards. I'm going to focus, though, I think, on coloring with blends on Tuesdays. So I'd love for you to join in. Thanks, Nan. Have a great weekend, and I'll see you all tomorrow. Bye-bye.